Joining me now to discuss the latest news regarding its Fraser Range tenements is Boadicea Managing Director John Reynolds. John, welcome to the show.
Thank you, Elisha.
Now, John, you've recently released some news regarding the Fraser Range licences. Give us a summary of this announcement.
Yeah, we've had some good news come out of some work we've done recently. So we've identified an EM target, an electromagnetic target, that's potentially, it's shown signals for potentially a massive sulphide target within Fraser Range, Fraser South Project, which is 100% owned by Boadicea. We have two licenses of our own that are 100% owned by us and managed. And we completed an EM survey a couple of months ago across both of those licenses. That's identified 11 targets. But more importantly, that one of them is highly conductive. And my geophysicist says that that's in the range of that could represent massive sulfide. So we're pretty excited by that. It's estimated to be about 170 metres depth. So that's it's very drillable in terms of getting identifying and testing the target.
So you've given us a bit of background there, but I really want to drill down. What is the significance of this massive sulphide target?
Yeah, massive sulphides. For the non-technical, it's where the mineralisation is composed 100% of sulphides. It doesn't relate to the size of the deposit or anything in terms of an area or quantity. It is more about the quality and the fact that it's 100% composed of sulphides. They are. Detectable through the EM targeting geophysical technique. Key interest too in the Fraser Range is that the Nova nickel mine is a massive sulphide deposit. Now I think most people will be aware that that's owned and operated by IGO. The EM target could also represent, as a sulphide, could also represent a volcanogenic deposit. So that's a VMS deposit. These are globally significant in terms of producing metal, mostly base metals, zinc, copper, sometimes gold, come from VMS deposits. So it has the potential of being a VMS, which there isn't an evidence of. IGO have discovered a VMS deposit about 100 kilometres to the north of us in the same geological unit. So we're pretty excited that we've got a potential massive sulphide target, and it could be a VMS or a Nova nickel style mineralisation.
John, am I right in saying this target is 100% owned by Boadicea and it lies outside your exclusive exploration agreement with IGO?
Yes, absolutely. This is the really exciting bit of that. This project, it is 100% owned by Boadicea. So we have 11 tenements in the Fraser Range covering 836 square kilometres from memory. Nine of these have formed part of that agreement that you mentioned, that whereby IGO have exclusive rights for 5 years. We've retained two licences. And the Snowy Project, as we've called it, this massive sulphide target, is within one of those licenses that we 100% own and manage. So, it's all ours. So we're looking forward to pushing through with this.
I'm glad you brought up the Snowy's prospect. Tell us, what are your next plans for this tenement?
This is now number one, well, not number one priority, but it's a high priority within the company now. This is an obvious target to drill test. So we've already started planning for that. We've got some environmental permits to get through, and obviously the heritage clearances, etc., that you need to do before you drill. But this is a high priority now for the company. So we'll be working frantically to try and get a drill rig on this as soon as possible.
Well, with lots of work already happening in the field and more to come, we look forward to further updates. John, thanks for your time.
Thanks, Alicia. Appreciate it.